Good morning, students. In our previous video, we have discussed that sound needs a medium to travel, and we have also verified this by the bell jar activity. So that's why sound waves are called mechanical waves, because they require material medium to travel. Now today let us discuss about the characteristics of a sound wave, or we can say it's the quantity which is used to describe a sound wave. So sound wave can be basically described by its frequency, amplitude, time period and wavelength. Sound can be graphically represented also as a wave, and there is change in the density and pressure as sound waves move in a medium. So when a sound wave travels through a material medium, then the density, or you can say the pressure of the medium, changes continuously from maximum value to the minimum value and vice versa. So now we shall discuss the first characteristics or quantities to describe a sound wave, and in this video today we are basically going to discuss about the wavelength of a sound wave. So wavelength is the distance between two successive or consecutive crest or trough, then the distance between the crest or trough is called wavelength. Now what is this crest or trough? Or you can say in the bracket it is written crest, bracket, in the bracket it is written compression, and trough in the bracket rarefaction. So what are these basically? So compressions, as we have already discussed, are the regions of high pressure and density where the particles are crowded and are represented by the upper portion of the curve, which means this, and this upper portion of the curve, and this is called crest. So this upper portion of a wave, is called crest. Whereas rarefactions are the regions of low pressure and density where the particles are spread out, means where the particles are far apart from each other, and they are represented by the lower portion of the curve, which is called trough. So this lower portion of a wave is called trough. So the upper portion is called crest and the lower portion is called trough. So the distance between two consecutive or successive crest or trough is called wavelength. So the this distance from this portion to this portion, from this to this portion, this is the crest, the upper part, this distance is called wavelength. Similarly, the distance between two successive troughs is also considered as wavelength. So this portion up to this portion, this is also called wavelength. This distance is also called wavelength. So I think wavelength is clear to you all. It is denoted by the letter, it is denoted by lambda, and it is denoted as letter this, the upside down Y, and it is read as lambda. Since the wavelength is the distance only, so its SI unit is meter. So I hope the wavelength is clear to you all. Firstly you have to understand about the crest or the compression or trough or the rarefaction. Compression is the crowded region where the particles are crowded, and rarefaction is the spread out region where the particles are far from each other, and that upper portion is called, where the particles are crowded, that is called crest, and the lower portion where the particles are spread out, that is called trough, denoted by the letter lambda, read as which is the upside down Y, and it is read as lambda, and SI unit is meter. So I hope the wavelength is clear to you. Now here in the figure you can see the shorter wavelength and longer wavelength. So this wave has shorter wavelength because you can see the distance between the two crest is small comparatively to this wave. So the second one has longer wavelength because the distance between the two crests is larger as compared to the first wave. Here the distance is small. Okay, that's it for today. In our next video, we are going to study the other characteristics of a sound wave. Thank you.